So the foundation in the headstand is you interlace your fingers with your pinky fingers side by side. So not one on top of another, but actually side by side. That allows for you to get a nice flat surface. Your elbows, you want the same width as your shoulders. So it makes a triangle. So you can go ahead and try that first before we even go anywhere, just making sure that you've got good alignment. The weight in headstand is going to be in your forearms. For the first few times that you do it, more than a few times, you're going to feel a lot of pressure at the top of your head. That's normal until you learn how to transfer the weight more into your forearms and elbows. But the way that I do headstand, the way that I teach it, so this is the first of this series, so next time we'll go deeper into it. But for this first one, you're going to come onto your knees. You're going to interlace your fingers, just like I said. Find your foundation. So I've got my foundation flat. You're not going to release your head down yet. What you're going to do is come up. So this is dolphin plank. So it's like down dog, except your forearms are released into the earth. My butt's really lifted. You can see now why we needed to open up the hamstrings, right? Because this is, if your hamstrings are super tight, you're going to start walking your feet forward and you're going to be bending your knees. That's not going to help. Your butt has to get as far over top of your shoulders, so you're stacking, as you can. So stay in your dolphin plank. You can stay here or you can start to walk it forward and then walk it back. And then walk it forward. And walk it back. Third time's a charm. Walk it forward. Pull your head through and take five full deep breaths. Remember to keep your legs fully engaged. Draw your heels towards the floor. And you keep pressing your head through your arms. One more breath. Release onto your knees, child's